They are asking us the conservation of the momentum can be understood from on the which basis we can understand the conservation of momentum. So we know that what does the conservation of momentum mean? So here they are particularly discussing the case of collision. So let us take the collision of the two particles. So we say that if the momentum before collision and momentum after collision of the system, we are not considering the momentum of the particular particle. We are considering the momentum of the system, whole system. If the momentum of the system before collision and momentum of the system after collision both are same, that is, there is no change in the momentum before and after collision, they are constant, then we say that momentum is conserved in this process. And one more thing, they are saying that there is no external force acting here, then we can consider that if there is an external force acting on the system is zero here, then the momentum will be conserved. So in order to understand where did we conclude that if the external force is equals to zero, then the momentum will be constant? We concluded it from the Newton's second law. We know that Newton's second law says that if there is external force acting on the system is equals to zero, then the momentum of the system, the rate of change of momentum of the system with respect to time will also be equals to zero. This means that the momentum of the system is equals to constant. Means the momentum of the system is not changing with respect to time. So where we concluded this conclusions that there is a conservation of momentum. The law of conservation of momentum holds when the external force acting on the system is zero. So what we concluded? Law of conservation of momentum. Okay. Law of conservation of momentum holds. So what we have concluded? The law of conservation of momentum holds when there is no external force acting on the system. So this was concluded. So in order to understand the conservation of momentum, we took the help of the Newton's second law. Means Newton's second law explained the conservation of momentum. Okay, the conservation of momentum can be understood from the Newton's second law. But not only with help of the Newton's second law, it can be also understood from the Newton's third law. That is, it says that if a particle exerts force on the other particle, that is, let it be FAB, then the other particle B will also exert the same amount of force, but it will exert the same amount of force in the opposite direction on the particle A. Here, for your kind information, the forces will not get cancelled because the forces acting are, though they are acting in the opposite directions and the equal amount of forces are acting, but they are acting on the two different bodies. Here, the forces don't cancel each other. That is, FAB plus FABA is not equals to zero. That is, here, the net force is not zero. Then you may get doubt that if the net force is not equals to zero, then the momentum should not be conserved. We may get doubt that. But for your kind information, as these forces are action-reaction pair, okay, the action and reaction pair, and for your kind information, the action-reaction pair are actually the internal forces. They are considered as internal forces. That is, the internal forces don't affect the moment. Here, they are actually internal forces. Okay. Here, though they are internal forces, so from here we can conclude that though there is no change, so though the internal forces are not equals to zero, though there is the action of internal forces between them, then also the momentum, our momentum of the system is conserved. That is, the momentum of the system is constant in this case. So during this whole process, this whole phenomena, though the internal forces are acting on the particles, though the internal forces on the system in the system are not equals to zero, then also our momentum of the system is conserved. Okay. So this means that the internal forces does not affect the momentum of the system. okay, they won't affect the momentum of the system. So we understood that the momentum can be conserved if the force is either internal, okay, and external force is zero, then the momentum will be conserved in this case. Okay, so this all we understood from the with the help of the Newton's second law as well as from the Newton's third law. So in order to understand the conservation of momentum, they both Newton's second law and Newton's third law were helpful.